Hello, welcome back to Salesforce Dealer. In this lecture, we will talk about the date and time library. So if you want to get more information about the date and time library, you can also see to our website. The website is www.salesforcedealers.com. After the opening this page, click on the Learn Python section. Drag down and click on date and time library. So date and time open lab, it is the open source library of the Python. We can fetch date time or any specific things with the help of this module. It is the open source library of the Python. So let's start about it. So open the command. So first things that, how to know your current date and time. So okay, so open Python. So import date and time. So x equals to date time dot date time dot now. Okay guys, so print x. So now you can see it's the current date and the time. Now if I want to print any specific year, month or day, suppose the month says 9th, it's a day. So it is a 13 and x dot year. So it is a 2020. Okay guys. So it is the all the things which is the which is you can, with the help of this thing, you can get the related information. So how to create a date object? So if I want to create a date object, how will you do? So x, suppose x is dot equals to date time dot date time dot, suppose so 2 is 9 and 12 and 20. Okay, so print x. So now you can see it is a particular object of this date. Okay guys, so now we are talking about some str f time method. So it's a method used to make the data object in a more readable string. So here is a lot of things that can be used for these things. So now we are starting from the percentile a. Okay, so let's see. First clear all the things, open the Python, import date time. Now suppose detail, it's my object name, the date time dot date time dot now. Okay guys, so now what we have to do, so detail dot str f time. Now we are using a percentile a. Okay guys, so what is a percentile a? It's written the weekend in less details. Okay, so let's enter. Okay, it is a Sunday. Now we will take the caps a, so it is written in the full detail. So now taking the capital A, so okay, it is a Sunday. Next thing is that is a percentile w. So it is written the weekend as a number. Okay, so it is written the weekend as a number. So it is zero. It means it's a Sunday. It's a one is starting the Monday. Okay, so now next thing is small b is written the month name in the short version. It is written the month name in the short version. It's SAP. Okay, if you want to use a capital B, so it is a full version. Okay, it's the September. Now next is the percentile D. So it is a day of month. Okay, so percentile D is a day of month. It is 13 is the day. Percentile M, return the month in a number. Okay. Okay, it is a month. It is a month is written into the number. Now we will take a small y, percentile Y. So return the year short version. Okay, so year in the start was in the 20. So it is a 2020. So that's why it is a give the 20. If you are using capital Y, then it will return the full again. So it, you could see, is a 2020. Next thing, that is the percentile. As it is the hour from the 0 to 24. Okay, take the H. Okay, it is 70. Is the time 17? Yeah, you can see. You can see in my watch is the 5. It is a 5:47. So it is the, if you are converting to the 24 zone, so it will be become the 17. Now, next is that is the I. Okay, so return is 0 to 12. Okay, now we have to turn the I. So okay, you can see it is a 5 o'clock right now. So next is that is a small p. So it's AM and PM. Okay, so anti-meridian and post-meridian. So we use the p. Okay, it's now this time it is a PM. Now next thing is, so M, return the minutes 0 to 59. Okay, let's take the capital M. Okay, it is the time is the 45. Of course, when we are creating orbit, that it is to take that 45. So that's why it is it's not changed yet. Now what we do, it's a capital S. So it's second 0 to 59. Okay, so it is a 43 second. Okay, F, return microsecond. Okay, F for the return microsecond is the microsecond. Now it is Z for UTC offset. Okay, it says UTC offset for use that. So capital Z is a time zone. Okay, so capital Z is a time zone. So return the day of year is the J. Return the day of the year. So the 257 day. U, return the weekend number of year starting from Monday. Okay, so weekend is the U. Let's use the U. Okay guys, this is the 37. Now C, return the local number, date and time. Okay, use the C. Sunday, September, that is time of the, it's local time. Now it's so X, return the local number date. Okay, now we are taking the local number date. So okay, 9, 9:30 and 20. So last is the capital X, return the local number in time. Okay, capital X. So now you can say it is the time and upper side is a date. So here is all the information regarding the date and time. I hope you enjoyed this video. So that's it for this session guys. So thanks for my watching video. Thank you guys.